everybody, to Carnival Central Mardi Gras 2014. We are here at the Hotel Intercontinental on the corner of Poitras and St. Charles Avenue, and we are now looking live at photos of Rex about to toast his queen. And Arthur Hardy, our Mardi Gras guide, is with us to tell us a little bit about this tradition. Not only that, but about the young lady who is about to take part in this ritual here, Arthur.
Yeah, I'm grabbing my notes here in a moment.
Her name was Carroll Gelderman.
Carroll Gelderman.
Yes, indeed.
You've got quite a stack, Arthur.
I do. I still have my Zulu papers here. I know she was surprised, and I know she's excited. And I think Randy Russo did our interview a couple of days ago with her and said she was just an absolutely delightful.
And she comes from a long legacy of a...
She does indeed.
Of royalty.
Yes, her mother was Rex, and she is at Columbia University, and I know she can't wait for Jack to stop and give her this ceremonial toast. I mean, this happens once in a lifetime, to be queen of Carnival.
And there's the mayor wobbling again.
Yep.
Just in case you missed it last year.
Well, he can't compete with the queen now.
He's been dancing all day long.
Here comes the toast.
Pomp and circumstance that goes along with it. Look at Mayor Michelangelo there on the left of your screen.
Majesty. Welcome to the hotel. Welcome to the Hotel Intercontinental New Orleans. Even on this day, it is interesting to note how many people are out looking at you. Looking at this beautiful parade, and we appreciate everything that you are doing. You know, you have been a remarkable citizen of this community for years, as you have served on more private and public boards than one can imagine. And in each case, those corporations and entities have been benefited by your remarkable advice and consent. You know, it's you're a remarkable energy combined with and imbued by your graduation in engineering and as a master in business has allowed you to truly give great advice to companies throughout, including, of course, those that deal with petroleum and fabrication, but more so maybe in this case to such entities as Tulane University, LSU Med School, the Audubon Institute, and of course the thing that you have spent so much time with, the Sugar Bowl Committee. As a matter of fact, there are those who think that the ghosts of Sugar Bowl Pass have been behind you on this, trying to protect your back all the way from Napoleon to here, and I think it's worked. So to all of you who are in and can hear my voice, may I suggest that you raise a glass and hail Rex 2014 Jack LaBorde.
Thank you very much. We'll take that
tour. Well, I have two troopers here with me this morning, my pages. Master John Charbonnet, Master Pipe Fitzhugh. Thank you for your help so far. We're here to honor. Honor our queen, Carroll Gelderman. Look forward to spending the evening with you. Hopefully it's a little drier than this. I just told the Archbishop he needs some new weather prayers. I'm going to email him some tomorrow. We also have some wonderful maids and dukes. Thank you for your cooperation today. Y'all look great. Appreciate it. Hope you're spending a wonderful evening this afternoon or tonight. We have an anniversary queen with us today. Miss Claudia Fitzhugh Kelleher. Wish her a great day. We also have with us the Queen of the LaBorde family, Peggy LaBorde. We will celebrate our 40th anniversary in a few months. Thanks for your patience, encouragement, and love. You're the love of my life. Thank you. I want to thank John Romano and the Intercontinental Hotel for keeping at least this section of the Rex Committee dry today. And without you, we couldn't do it. But thank you. Thanks for your kind words. Thanks to the crowd for coming out today. All y'all got to be crazy, too. But this is what we do in New Orleans. And Homer, this isn't a bad day. Thank you, Mr. President. We're going to get running because the weather's so bad. But I appreciate it. Thank you for all you do. I want to present the Queen a set of some flowers we have. I'm sorry. Sorry, Carol. Got a little in a hurry. But thank you.
Well, thank you.
We have some Weiss flowers, too. I'm not doing too well today. Thanks, John.
You'd love to sit here in this beautiful weather and listen to me all day. I'm going to keep it short, so here's to you, Rex. What a glorious king you are. I feel so blessed to be sharing this rain with you, and I hope you're having a great time out there. And I know it's raining, but we're still rolling. Nothing can stop Rex, and nothing can stop the people of New Orleans from celebrating. So happy Mardi Gras to everyone. Hail Rex.
May we never cease to love, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Captain, let's roll.
He gave his young queen.
You have to love him, huh?
Yeah, this is a king like none other I've seen in quite some time, I have to tell you. Again, he says, we're all crazy here.
Right.
But then he praised her. He praised her for all of her community service and her dedication to the community and all that seriousness under all the royalty and the fun of it all.